Karen Burniston, here with the latest 6 Stage It stencils. Let's look first at the 3 new layering stencils. So the way the layering stencils work is that you use the top half of the stencil, so this portion here, in one color, and then you move it up and use a second color in the other half of the stencil. Just like the previous Stage It stencils, there's an overall pattern area of 4 3/8 by 6 1/8. Now these are layering stencils, so that means half of the stencil is going to be used for one color and half for the other color. So it's going to combine to make an overall pattern of 4 3/8 on the width by 3 inches tall. However, you can also just extend the pattern. So you can do this little 2-step layering process, then you can pick your stencil up, move it over, repeat that until you've done a much larger area if that's what you need on your project. The stencil I'm demonstrating first is the Cherries layering stencil, and what I'm doing here is taking some green ink with a blending tool and I'm just swirling it around and through the top half of the stencil to create all the stems and the leaves. Once I've inked all of that half of the stencil, I can lift it off of there. Just so you can see, I do have the leaves, I do have the stems. Now all I do is just slide that stencil straight up. And I can see through it, so I can definitely check and make sure that those cherries are lined up with the stems below. But it really is quite easy to do this. And then all I have to do is switch to my other color. So I'm making cherries, so I will switch to a red. And once again, I'm just going to swirl that ink with a blending tool right through the stencil. A nice feature of the Stage It stencils is their durability. The pattern is going to hold up for you even if you're doing, like you're seeing me do here, kind of a swirling technique with your ink so that you can push that ink out to the edges of the openings where the little cherries are. Don't feel like your pattern's going to move on you if you do that. You are not limited to only pouncing through these stencils. And of course, you're also not limited to just using ink. These stencils are going to work great with paint, with sprays, with pastes, with all sorts of materials. Here's the big reveal. Off comes the stencil, and you've got that adorable little 2-part cherries pattern. Now that's a pretty decent size for the background of a card, but if you needed more area, just move the stencil and start over again, and you can make it as large as you'd like. The team has been killing it with the new Stage It stencils. Check out this super cute card by Fran Sabad. She's Baker the Beaver. I love that she added a little cherry to his cupcake. And then here is a card by Kelly Booth, amazing. She used the cherries on the front of the card and also inside and die cut it as part of the hot air balloons. I mentioned using paste with the stencil. Here's a great card by Raquel Mason where she did that. She used translucent paste with some red glitter on the cherries themselves. The next layering stencil is S008, the Baby Pajamas. Now in this case, you could use just the pajamas at the top or just the hearts at the bottom. But if you want to combine them, you do the top half in your first color, just like with the cherries, you slide it straight up. Once you see hearts over the top of the little baby pajamas, then you switch to your second color to add those hearts. And it'll add hearts both on the pajamas as well as a set around the pajamas. So you'll see how fun this little pattern is. There is a charm in the new Baby Charms die set that actually is this same little pajama with a little stitched edge and a heart in the middle, so you can see how nicely those two combine together on this card by Fran Sabad. Kelly Booth also combined the Baby Pajamas layering stencil, this time in boy colors, with the little bunny charm that comes in that same Baby Charms die set. And you're also seeing some of the new baby greetings from the clear stamp set used on these samples. Here's one by Sandy Diller, where she only used the pajamas part of the stencil. She actually did not slide up and use the heart, so you always have that option. The final layering stencil in this collection is S009, which is the Blossom layering stencil. And here's another one where you could use just the top portion that has the flowers, or you could maybe use just the bottom portion that has the dots. But when you do slide the dots up over the flowers and ink them in a second color, you will get a really cool 2-tone flower. And I particularly love what Raquel Mason did on this card, where she actually sponged white ink through the stencil and then used black for the flower centers. It just makes a great little background. The other 3 new Stage It stencils are all over pattern stencils. And what I thought I'd do on this video is show a couple fun techniques with pattern stencils. So this first one is I'll just show you how to use it for embossing. When you emboss a stencil, you're going to use the same sandwich in your machine that you would use for embossing a wafer thin die. If it's not a Sizzix Big Shot, just Google or YouTube it so you can find out what that sandwich is. You'll need a silicone and impressions pad if you're using a Sizzix Big Shot. Those go on top of tab 1 in your machine, and then you put on your cardstock. Now, I like using a core cardstock. This is soft finish, so it's got white underneath. And then I'm going to put my new Gears stencil down over that stack, cutting pad on top, and roll it right through my Big Shot machine. It's really the silicone rubber pad that's in the sandwich that really works all the magic. That's what squishes that paper up through that Gears stencil and allows it to be used as an embossing plate. So now you can see those cool raised gears. If I really want them to show up, since I did use a core cardstock, I can go in with a sanding block and just sand off the top of the black. It's only going to sand it over the top of the gears since they are embossed, and then that'll really reveal that pattern. Sandy Diller embossed the gear stencil. For this card, she actually did not end up sanding it. You get that really cool tone on tone. And both Sandy and then Francis, with their steampunk cards, have incorporated the gear stencil along with the new steampunk charms and the steampunk greetings clear stamps. But of course, the gears also make great backgrounds, even in brighter colors like this fun birthday card that Karen Aiken made for her grandson. The next technique I'll show is partial masking, and I'll use the new rain stencil for that. One of the things I tried to think about with the new charms dies that have come out in the spring collection is to be able to use them as props with the characters wherever possible. So the little umbrella charm that comes in the baby charm set is actually a perfectly sized prop for the characters. Just cut off the hang hole at the top and then just glue it to a character. So in this case, I'm using Lucky the Rabbit. Now I've also cut a couple pieces of grass using the grass edges from the outdoor edges. And I'm just kind of temporarily building my little scene so that I can figure out where Lucky the Rabbit is going to end up in my finished card front, so that I can temporarily put him into place and then use the rain stencil to add rain to the background. Now what I want to do is I want to actually mask off the raindrops that are going to be underneath the umbrella. So all I'm using is some temporary Scotch removable tape, and I'm just, since I can see through the stencil, I can just go in there and just mask off the lines of raindrops that would be below the umbrella on the finished card. Then I can remove the stencil while I take Lucky off of the card, because that was just to figure out the placement, and then put the stencil back in place again and sponge on the ink that's going to create the raindrops. Masking off the raindrops that I don't need just gives me a little peace of mind. I don't have to worry so much as I'm inking that the ink may stray into the area where I didn't want any ink. It's masked off. I don't have to worry about it. I'm not going to accidentally get any ink through the raindrops that would be underneath the umbrella. So just a very simple little card front, a couple pieces of grass at the bottom, some glue behind Lucky and his umbrella, and then I'll just place that into the area so that it looks like the umbrella is shielding the rain. And of course, the umbrella charm is going to work great with the baby clear stamps and the rain stencil when you want to do a baby shower card, like this cute one by Summer Hills Painter. So I have one stencil left to show, and I've got one more technique that I thought I might share, which is how to make your own glitter paste. So I'm starting with a translucent paste, and honestly, there are several brands of this. I'm using the Dreamweaver brand, but Ranger makes it. You know, just Google it, you'll find lots of choices of translucent embossing or texture paste. And I'm starting with some of that, and then I'm going to add in a couple colors of Elizabeth Craft Design Silk Microfine Glitter. So this is kind of cool because you can kind of mix the colors and make your own custom colors if you want to in the paste. And then I just need to mix that all together. The stencil I'm using is the new Petite Flourish stencil, and the actual little flourish shape is the same shape that is the cutout on the wedding dress for the new wedding charms. So this is a great stencil to use with those wedding charms, although of course it's going to be a great generic stencil to use for all sorts of other themes. When you're making your custom glitter paste, you really don't have to make that much. It is surprising how far it will stretch. You can get all the way across this entire stencil with a relatively small amount of paste. I'm using a palette knife to spread mine, but you could definitely use just a credit card or an old gift card or something to spread it. And then once you have all of the area covered with the paste, it's just a matter of carefully peeling up the stencil to get it off of there. And then you just need to set that aside to dry. It will take a while to dry, but once it does dry, it will become very, very shiny. Let me show a couple of the cards from this month's challenge using the Petite Flourish stencil. This one by Shelley Hickox, a great wedding card by Francis Byrne, and this one, which just cracks me up, a Game of Bones card by Kaz Council. So cleanup of the stencils is pretty easy. I generally just use water. If it's just like ink, I'll just spray it with a little bit of water, mist it, and just use a paper towel or a rag to clean them up. If it's something like paste or paint or something, I might sink it into some water and then use a very light scrub brush to just get those pastes off of there. So just go careful when you're scrubbing it with a brush, but they will hold up. They are actually a very durable stencil. I'm just going to dry it off with some paper towels and it is ready for my next project. Elizabeth Craft Designs products are sold worldwide. You can go to elizabethcraftdesigns.com to find out where you might find the Stage It stencils in your area. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Facebook, Karen Burniston Designer, and you'll always find more ideas on my blog, karenburniston.com. Thanks for watching.